All right, everybody. So we're going to go ahead and get started. For today, we're going to have Coach Jose warm you guys up, and then we'll talk about what we have in terms of the program. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure I spotlight Coach. You guys can all see Coach. Just make sure you guys can see him. I'm going to go ahead and put part of the warm-up in the chat just so you guys can see it too. But just go ahead and follow Coach Jose's lead. So everybody go ahead and stand up and just pay attention real quick, okay?
Ladies and fellas, welcome all. All right, so what we're gonna do is just give you some 12 circles going forward. And that's a big 12 circles going forward. Excellent. Beautiful. Once you go forward, you're going to go back. Snap arms. Both circles going back. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to get into the tabletop position. So basically, we're going to have on our hands, we're going to be on our knees, okay? In this position, hold your hands on the ground. The opposite side. Five on each side. Five on this side, five on the other.
Five per side, y'all. Five.
When you're done with that, still stay on the ground. All right, the next one, we're gonna go into a child's pose. Let's get into that child's pose. Wide, hips back, arms and fall. Now from here, let's go to the right. The lat stretch. Hold it there. Go to the right. Hold it. Excellent. And recover. Well done. All right, folks. For now, what's going to happen? We're going to do something called a comfort stretch. So what's going to happen? This leg will come out. This is like it is never touching the ground. Since my left leg is out, my left arm will reach the ground in the opposite hand here. Next, I will go down as far as I can. Twist towards the front leg. Then what I'm going to do is straighten the leg and reach for the toe. All right, let's do the right side again. Right leg out, right arm down to the ground. Twist towards the front leg. Bring in the front leg.
There you go.
Reach for the toe. We just did two. We did three more on each side. Again, here. The arm to that leg. There you go. Make sure after you twist that you straighten the leg out and reach for the toe. Hold on. Once you're done, I'll have you ladies stand up, please. Next one, we're going to do four on each side of a standing stretch. So my arms will be locked up. I will lunge, then turn towards the front leg, and then step. And then do the other side, twist, and then step. Give me four on each side.
There we go.
Go. Lunge and then twist. Those arms up. You're beautiful. Here you go, ladies. Thanks, man.
Can't nobody know me like you do. When you look at me, you see right through me. And I see you.
Now we can just stand up. All right, next one, we're going to do five on each side of Kaza squat. So I'm going to go pretty wide. Go as low as I can. And then come up. And do the other side, low as I can. And then come up. Take your time, please.
There we go. Awesome. Good job, Sasha. Okay. Let's bring it over. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna review two different movements. The first one we'll review is a split squat, but we'll be jumping on the split squat. And then for the other movement, we're gonna introduce you guys how to go from the floor to overhead with one arm. And we're gonna give you guys two different options for that today, okay? So if we go back to Coach Jose, for the split squat, what we're gonna have you guys do is get in the lunge position to where the front leg has a vertical shin. So when coach goes down, you're gonna see a straight line up and down from his ankle up. All right, and what we're gonna practice today is going from that lunge position to jumping out of it. All right, what you can do is the way Coach Jose did it where he lands on 2 feet, which will allow you to jump higher and you'll be more comfortable landing safely, or you can jump and switch legs every single time. Okay, so let's go ahead and have you guys get in that lunge position. And we want you guys to try and do 5 per side. So you're gonna get down that lunge position, focusing on keeping your chest up. You're gonna then drive out of it and either land with both feet or switch legs. We can let you guys decide what you wanna do. Let's go for it. So 5 per side, so in total you're doing 10. Here we go. Good one, Kendall. There you go, Sky. Good job. Can you do a couple more just so everybody can see? Good reps. Awesome. Okay. For the other movement we want to review and demonstrate today, all right, it's going to be from the floor to overhead in one motion. So you can use a book, you can use a water bottle, you can use a dumbbell. The whole point is it needs to be something that you can hold and have a full grip on. Coach is going to start with it touching the floor between his feet, and his setup position is going to have his chest up. From here, you have two options. You can either bring it up to your shoulder and then stop at your shoulder and then press it up, and then he would press up and then bring it back down and switch hands. There you go, coach. Nice. Or you can bring it all up in one motion, just like coach is doing. But the big thing is if you bring it up in one motion, you gotta look like the letter I, not like the letter Y. You don't wanna look like that. That's a no-no. You wanna have everything in a nice straight line overhead. That's a good rep. All right, so you have two options again. You either stop at the shoulder and then press, or you go all in one motion, which is a little more difficult, and then you bring it back down. Let me have everybody go ahead and do 10 reps switching arms. So you switch every single time. There we go, nice, Kendall. So it touches the floor every single rep. and then it goes all the way up overhead every single time. Nice guy. All right, so the big thing is going to be when it's over your head, your arm is locked out. There you go, Willow. Awesome job, you guys. Good. All right, so we've done the variation with both hands. This is our first time going with one hand, okay? Good work, y'all. All right. So other movements we have today, and I'm going to put them up, are going to be lemon squeezes or tuck-ups, which I'll show Coach real fast now so he can demo. Coach, I'll let you talk about this one while I bring everything up. So you either tuck your knees to your chest and bring your arms around your knees, or if you want to go harder, you can have your legs straight out if you'd like, and then fold in half or V up. This is totally up to you. Boop. All right, so that's the harder one, or you can do the tuck up. Other moves we'll have later on will require you to do lunges overhead. All right, so if you're using a book or a water bottle, you're gonna hold it with both hands and you're gonna lock it out over your head and perform forward lunges. So the goal for this is gonna be to keep your arms locked down and chest up as you lunge. And we have everybody go ahead and do 10 of those now. So now you get to do lunges with the weight up over your head with arms locked out all the way. Nice, Kendall.
Here you go, lock them out, lock them out.
So you should be pressing up. We should see no bend in the arm. So press up a little more, Sasha. There you go. Awesome job, awesome job. Good reps. All right, and then the last move we'll go over for today is going to be the burpee tuck jump, all right? So for that one, you're gonna perform your burpee, and then when you jump, you're gonna tuck your knees to your chest. So watch Coach real fast. And go all the way down, chest touches the floor, and then jump and tuck his knees. Watch his feet, how they land in squat position, and then jump and land again in his squat position every single time. All right, that's a burpee tuck jump. Let me have everybody go ahead and do four of those now, please. Let me have everybody go ahead and do four of those. I see all the smiles already. So four reps, burpee, and then jump and tuck. Yeah, nice guy. Awesome, Kendall.
Good, Kendall.
Okay.
Move these high.
Good job. All right. So I'm going to switch it back to me real quick. Our first portion of the workout today, you're going to work for 3 minutes in a row. And during those 3 minutes, you're going to do eight of the core movement, which is the tuck up or the V up. You'll then stand up. You're going to do six reps where you pick the weight up from the floor and go all the way up overhead. That one you get to alternate arms. So it's going to be three per side. And then you have four jumping split squats. So it'll be eight, six, and four. You're going to go through that cycle as many times as you can in 3 minutes. And then we'll get a minute break and I'll explain the next portion. But we're always going to work for 3 minutes and then get 1 minute off. 3 minutes on, 1 minute off. 3 minutes on, 1 minute off. Does that make sense, everybody?
Wait, can you repeat what we have to do again?
Yeah, so the first one will be the tuck-ups. So watch, I'll have Coach go through it in order. So movement number one is the tuck-ups or V-ups. So he'll do his lemon squeezers. So let's say he does eight, six, seven, eight. He then stands up. Once he does eight, perfect. He'll then grab his book and do six reps alternating sides. So that's one, two, fast forward to six. He'll then put his book down and do his split squats with the jump. One, two, three, four, and then he goes right back to the tuck-ups. So the reps are short on purpose, so then you're cycling through all of these different movements over and over and over. Sound good? So eight tuck-ups, six, ground to overhead, and then four jumping lunges. All right. So I'll be running the clock. Just so you guys know, we'll be going in about 15 seconds. So make sure you have your bottles near you. You can start on the ground. We'll go in five, four, three, two, Juan, let's go. 3 minutes of work, 8 tuck-ups. You can do it, Sky. Tuck your knees in and kick out. There you go. Kick out every single time. You got 8 of these. Nice work. And stand up. 6 going from the floor all the way up. Switching arms every time. Nice job, Damon. Good job. And then you have 4 jumping lunges. And then you go back to the tuck-ups. 8, 6, 4. You got it, girls.
Where'd he go? Where'd he go?
Nice job, everybody.
Great, Dana.
There you go, Willow. The arm goes all the way up overhead every time. Good work, Kimberly. Awesome job, y'all.
Looking good.
Keep it up, ladies. We're coming up to the halfway point.
Great job, Kendall.
Good job, good job, good job. Keep cycling through. Let's see if we can get 4 or 5 sets in there. Keep pushing. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Good job. Always lock it out. You got it, Sky. Good job. Just keep cycling through, y'all. You're doing great.
Bring it, bring it.
Got a little over 30 seconds left. Trying to get a full set in there.
Wait, move it, Dana.
There we go. We got 20 seconds left. There we go, girls. Keep it up. Go, everybody. You got this. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, catch your breath. I'm going to direct your attention to the coach again. All right, the next session, all right? Same scheme, 8 reps, 6 reps, 4 reps. The first 8 are squats. You're going to be holding the weight you use. Okay, so you'll hold the weight out in front of you. You're going to squat 8 times. Once you finish your 8 squats, hold the weight over your head. And then you'll do your 6 lunges. And then you'll have your 4 burpee tuck jumps. So 8 squats, 6 lunges, 4 burpee tuck jumps. That's the next part. And we're up in about 20 seconds. All right, we get to do another 3 minutes. So go ahead and make sure you have your weights with you. We're starting off with the squats in 10 seconds. All right, y'all, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 8 squats to start. Good job, nice, Kendall. Once you finish squat number 8, get your weight overhead. You got 6 lunges, arms locked out overhead. Really press up the whole time. And then you got 4 burpee tuck jumps. She sips a Coke. You got it, y'all. Let's get it.
Way to go. Let's move it.
Yeah, nice guy. So everybody, keep pushing. You got this. It's always 8 squats, 6 lunges, 4 burpee tuck jumps. We're already 1 minute in. Let's keep moving. There you go, Willow.
That's right, that's right. Chest to the ground, chest to the ground, Willow. There you go.
There we go. Let's go. Keep it up, y'all. You got this. There you go, Willow. Remember, hips back first. That's like you're sitting in a chair.
Great squats. Get it. Come on.
Go. We've got 1 minute left. Let's keep going. There we go. Good burpees. Nice work.
Work it, ladies.
30 seconds left. Tuck those knees up. Tuck those knees. There we go, y'all. 15 seconds. Last 10. Then we get a break again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, everybody rest. Okay, so take a sip of water. When we come back to work in less than a minute, we go back to the first one. You'll do your 8 tuck ups. Your 6 reps, do you switch arms every single time from the floor up overhead? And then your jumping lunges, okay? Or your jumping split squats. All right, so take a sip of water. You guys are back up in a little over 30 seconds, okay? You guys are doing great. Any words of encouragement, Coach?
Now that we've done 2 rounds, the next 3 rounds, try to maintain a pace that you can maintain. So think about sustaining, not sprinting. It's all about sustaining.
Awesome, brother. All right, everybody, we're up in 15 seconds. We start on the ground with the tuck-ups. Everybody on the ground, we're up in 10.
Deep breaths, come on.
You guys got this. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 8 tuck ups.
Let's get it.
Nice. Once you're done with those 8, you got 6 going from the floor overhead.
Oh, excellent, Dana. Lightweight.
I'm talking about. Good job, y'all. You guys are crushing it. Once you finish your 6, you got 4 jumping split squats. There we go. You guys are doing awesome.
Beautiful work.
Just like that, nice and steady. Find that pace and ride that wave. Great job.
Hi.
Yeah, we're halfway through. Keep working. There you go, Willow. Good job, y'all.
Go, Sasha.
Okay. We should have got less than a minute left.
Come on.
You guys are doing great. We got a little over 30 seconds left. Turn it on now. Good job. Keep it going, keep it going. We got about 10 seconds left.
Oh.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Everybody rest. Great job, y'all. All right, we've done 3 out of the 5 sets. We got 2 left. We get to go back to the 8 squats, 6 overhead lunges, and 4 burpee tuck jumps. So enjoy your little break. We're back on in about 40 seconds. You guys are doing great. You guys are doing great. Keep it up. What's up?
What's the first one?
8 squats, 6 squats. Lunges, and then 4 burpee tuck jumps.
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome. You're welcome. How you doing, Coach?
Great, yeah.
Everybody's doing a great job.
Demonstration got me tired.
Yeah, everybody's doing a great job. Okay, so let's all stand up. We're up in about 10 seconds. Grab your weights.
All right, let's get mentally ready.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's squat. You got 8 squats.
Go chest up. Let's go, Willow. Send the butt back first.
After your 8 squats, lock it out overhead. You're lunging.
Go, Kendall.
The chest to the floor on the burpees. Tuck those knees up nice and high. And softly. There we go, y'all. Let's go.
There it is. There it is.
Oh, you're doing a great job. Let's keep it going.
Go chest up, Willow.
There we go.
Get it, get it.
All right, we're coming up at the halfway point of this one. Let's get it.
Get a little lower gain on the squats.
There we go, y'all. Let's get it.
Excellent. Lock those arms on the overhead squats. Great correction.
Got a minute left. Let's get it. You got it. You got it. There you go.
Better bring
keep
it.
Keep going. Keep going. You guys are doing great. Let's go. A little over 20 seconds left. Let's go. Get as many reps as you can. There we go. Let's go, SG. Keep it up. 10 seconds.
All the way through.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax.
Hi.
Everybody catch your breath.
Woo.
got one more left. All right, we get to go back to that first one. We're going to finish off with that. Then we'll get a nice little break before we close things out with a nice little core program. And I'm going to throw in a little bonus today, too. We'll have a nice little cash out. So in a little over 30 seconds, we get to go back to the top, which will be our 8 tuck-ups, 6 where we're going to lift from the floor to overhead, and then our jumping lunges, okay? So take a sip of water. You guys are doing a fabulous job. We're up again in about 15 seconds. So once you're done drinking water, you can take a seat on the ground. You start with those tuck-ups. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's work. Let's go, y'all. All
right, ladies, get them abs. Let's go straight to it. Snatches, Dana. Snatches. There you go, Dana. Snatches. Yeah, so it's, there you go.
Good job, y'all. Number 8 tuck-ups, 6 going from the floor to overhead, and then 4 jumping lunges. Nice job, Panda. Almost there. Keep it up. Got about 2 minutes.
Stay in it.
There we go. Yeah, let's get it. Halfway.
Got a girl.
Coming up on that 1 minute left, so keep going. Yes. They're doing a great job of being consistent. Let's keep it up. 1 minute left. You got it, Sky.
Boom.
Here we go, y'all. Keep it up. Nice. You smooth the whole time. I dig it.
Come on, ladies, last round.
All right, let's go, let's go, let's go. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, everybody rest. Good work all around. Great job. All right, so catch your breath. In a second, we'll change things over. And we're going to talk about what we're doing for our core program today. For core, we'll go 3 times through. We're going to do our hollow holds into scissor kicks going in and out. So rather than going flutter, which is up and down, we're going to go out and in. And then we're going to do a straight legged sit up. So the first movement, the most important part is going to be making sure your low back is what stays on the floor. So coach is going to do his best to lay back. And then he's going to tuck his knees up first. And once his knees are tucked, he's going to feel that his low back's on the ground. All right, from here, he's going to then raise his shoulders off the floor and reach toward his shoes. All right, from this position, he can then take his feet off the ground, keeping his knees tucked, and hold there. If he wants to make it harder, he can kick one leg out. and then still hold there. And if he wants to make it the hardest, he'll kick both legs out. Damn. All right, so what's going to happen from here? Once 20 seconds pass, we'll do scissor kicks. So he's going to bring his legs out and in. Once you do 20, you'll then drop down with your legs straight and perform 10 straight-legged sit-ups. There we go. All the way up and down 10 times. Okay. Sound good, y'all? Thumbs up for my camera peeps. I love it, love it. If you have a camera, please tilt it so then we can see to correct you guys. Yeah.
For the scissor kicks, is it okay if I have my hands underneath my back? Because when I sprain my
knee,
it's like when push out, it hurts.
Yeah, so you can have your hands under your back to help protect that. What I would recommend first and foremost would be to start with your knees bent and get used to doing it with your knees bent. But if you need to have that there so you can try to extend a little more, then that's okay as well. All right. Give me a thumbs up if you're ready. So I'm going to reference the camera peeps. Awesome. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right, we're going to do our hollow hold first. All right. 20 seconds. We're going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Everybody hold. Tuck the knees up. Slowly extend down and reach. Just hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Awesome. Good, 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 good. Keep holding, y'all. 3, 2, 1. Let's do 20 reps coming in and out. And once you finish your 20 reps, legs straight. And then 10 sit-ups. So legs straight once those are done. 10 sit-ups all the way up and down, just like Coach is doing. Awesome. Awesome. Good, 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 good. Once you're done, just sit up for me so I know you're done.
You gotta just really reach some toes.
Awesome. We'll get going again in about 20 seconds. You're doing great. Great work so far. All right. So that's one set down. Smile. We'll get going back to the hollow hold. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Tuck and hold. Here we go. 20 seconds. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Good job. Nice handle. 3, 2, 1. 20 reps in and out. Let's go. Good work. Once you finish those 20, that 10 set up to be like straight. Good job, y'all. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up.
Good job.
Once you're done, just take a seat so you know you're done. Awesome. I'll give us time to regroup. We'll go again in about 15 seconds. Last time through, and then I'm going to throw in a bonus move before we stretch. All right, we're up in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, tuck and hold, 20 seconds. There we go. If you want to make it hard, you can kick one leg out and then hold that. And then really reach towards the feet. There you go. 3, 2, 1, 20 reps. There we go. Keep it up, keep it up. And you got your 10 sit-ups, your legs straight. Nice job, y'all. This is the last time here. Awesome. All right. So the bonus movement is going to be a 1 minute wall sit. So you're going to watch Coach go up to the wall. He's going to have his whole back and shoulders up against the wall. He's going to get down to his squat position and just make sure he pushes those knees out. And he's going to hold this. So his thighs are what's going to be burning. All right. So it's the top of his legs. We're going to hold that for 1 minute. Let's see if everybody can hold that position. So I'm going to give you guys time to find somewhere to do this. And then once I see that everybody's found a spot, I'll get us going, but no rush. All right, all right. Awesome. I'm going to do a 1 minute wall sit. Okay. All right, y'all, we're going to go in 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Wall sit, everybody. Shoulders, back, glutes against the wall. Let those thighs burn. There we go. Nice. Sit and hold, sit and hold. Awesome job. Got that about now. It should start burning. It hasn't yet. Yeah. Yes. Keep it up. We're almost 40 seconds in. You guys are doing great. There we go. Last 10 seconds. Let's get it. There we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, time for a squat burnout. Everybody, 20 squats and then we're done. 20 squats. Everybody, 20 squats.
Go.
There's no weight now. 20 squats. That's what I'm talking about right here. Once you do your 20, you're all done. Good job, y'all.
There you go, Scott.
Hey, damn. And then once you're done, you can take a seat. Good job, y'all. I'm going to bring it back to Coach. Coach, I'll let you talk about these stretches for cool down, but we'll do some pigeon pose. We'll hold thread needle and child's pose for today. Okay. Everybody, go ahead and give your attention to Coach.
Wait. What we're going to do, ladies, we're going to start in a downward dog position first. I'm going to bring my right leg up and then bring it here. Now, what you want to do is have the back leg straight. Try to have this lower leg go side to side, not in. If this hurts, you can go in. Aim to do this. You can stay here. We can go on your forearm. And let's hold for 30 seconds.
Awesome. All right, y'all. Find that position. I'll start a clock in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're holding. Time to stretch. There we go. Hold it, hold it, hold it. We got 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly come out.
Great, go back to that downward dog position. pump your legs a little bit. All right, bring up the left leg. Bring it forward.
Awesome, new leg and hold it. Look through, Kendall. Remember, y'all, it's getting warm, so you guys need to stay hydrated after you go out and do any sort of moving. And you should also be stretching when you wake up and before you go to bed. It's going to benefit you in the long run. All right, so static stretches like this will benefit you after you work out. All right, so don't do static stretches before you work out. And rest. Back to coach.
Excellent. Excellent legs. Let's get into this this tabletop position. We're going to start with the right arm. We're just going to go down. We're just going to hold it. So my right shoulder will come down. My left arm, I will push. And I'll just look at the ceiling.
There we go. Let's all find that and hold. It's going to be 30 seconds long. Just make sure you send your hips back too if you can. There you go, y'all. Just keep holding. I'll let you guys know when to switch. Don't worry. So switch in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch sides. There you go, y'all. Keep holding. Five, four, three, two, one. Now you can reach overhead and go right into child's pose. Watch coach reach back or reach out and send your hips back. So your hips should be down. Good. And just hold. Use this as a chance to just wind down. So nice deep breaths and relax. There we go. Solid. Nice and calm now. Reach, 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 relax. Keep holding. We got another 20 seconds. Final 10 seconds. Three, two, one. All right, y'all, go ahead and relax. Ooh, slowly come out of that. Okay, okay. All right, so bring it back over. So, y'all, if you are feeling a little sore or thirsty or whatnot, or you feel like in the middle of these workouts, not to say that you are, but if you feel like you're cramping, those are signs of dehydration. So just make sure that you guys are staying hydrated. And when I say stay hydrated, it doesn't mean just chug water all at once. You should be sipping water throughout the day. Don't ever try to just sit down and just drink a whole water bottle in one sitting, because that's going to actually hurt you more than it helps you. Your body needs to be fueled constantly, not all at once, okay? So if you're feeling extra sore tonight, just make sure you stretch, because we will be back tomorrow and we'll be back again Saturday, right? So tomorrow's gonna be also at 5 o'clock, and then Saturday will be at 11 a.m., all right? So continue taking care of yourselves. I'm gonna switch it back over to coach, and then he can say his bye.
Great job, ladies. I saw some great movements. I love it. I will see you tomorrow. All right, great work.
Awesome. And then y'all, just to add one more thing, y'all have been doing a really great job of progressing forward and finding a way to still keep moving through all of this. So keep signing in, keep working out, because it is going to benefit you. And then we'll all be back on the court real soon, okay? So take care of yourselves, and we'll see you guys all soon.
Yes, thank Sasha, at 11.
Yep. Sasha, 11 a.m. Saturday. All right.
Of course, Dana.
Have a great one, you guys. We'll see you all soon.
Thank
you. Bye, all. Great seeing you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye, guys.